Hello. Today we are going to be disassembling a Roborock vacuum in order to get at all those hard to reach places in the case that it has sucked up something gooey, such as pudding. The tools for this job are a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, a number 1 Phillips screwdriver, and the optional tools are 2 flat blade screwdrivers, any size, and a pick. Additionally, you're going to want a vacuum cleaner available, and of course a sink to wash things in. I also did have a new main brush, new side brush, and a new filter on hand. Before we proceed, we will need to fully shut down the vacuum. Hold down the power button. So I've already gone ahead and removed the dustbin with filter, as well as the main brush and the side brush. I can link to one of my other videos that show how to do that. That's kind of the regular simple stuff. I'm going to put these parts in the bucket to wash. The brushes and the filter, I have new ones that I'm just going to put in there instead of trying to clean out the old one. First thing we're going to do is remove this wheel. The way to remove it is actually fairly simple. You grab onto it and pull. There we go. You put your finger, kind of latch it on and pull one side and then pull the other, and it just pops right out. One area I really want to clean is this area where all the dirt and debris travels through to get from the main brush area over to the dustbin. You can see it's kind of flexible there. I want to get that piece out so I can really get a good wash on it. But in order to do that, I need to take this section off. So I'm going to get a screwdriver, regular Phillips-drive, and start taking those screws out. The last screw that's located right over here actually has a little piece of some kind of thin rubber or a sticker that covers it. I believe that this lets the factory know that you have opened this vacuum up. So if you're concerned about preserving your warranty, you might not want to take that piece of plastic off. Not that it really comes off, it really just tears once you try to pick at it. So once you've done that, then you can take the screw out. This particular unit is already out of warranty, so I'm not concerned about losing warranty protection for this. Then we lift straight up. This is what we find once we remove that cover. As you can see, it's quite dusty, so you could use this opportunity to remove any excess dust that might be here. As to this part that I really want to remove here, you can see that it hinges here and here when it moves this way. So to get it out, you can actually just do it using your hands. I'm going to use my finger to push inwards here onto the hinge. And later, same thing in the other direction to just get it out of the way. So be careful, because this is plastic. You don't want to break it. You only want to push it just enough to get it out of this area. So I'm doing it carefully and slowly. There we go. It just popped out. You can see here. That's where I just pushed it out. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay. There we go. You can see it's out here and here. Now, in order to take this part out, what you need to do is flip the unit over. Notice I have my finger on the battery to keep the battery from falling out. And you're going to go over to this rubber section and pull it gently, pry it up off of the little plastic studs, I guess you could call them. Just prying like that, all the way around, gently. And then once that's off the studs, you can actually push it right in so it's ready to come out on the other side. Now, with this part, I'm going to try to push it a little bit in that direction because there is a area where it kind of overlaps and you have to get it out from under it. There, one side. And the same thing over here. There we go. So now that we can move this, you're going to actually tilt it up very gently and try to rotate it here. There is a wire that goes to this area because the motor that turns the brush, you can see it right there, it's that silver cylinder, is actually connected to this piece. So in order to not have to undo all the wiring for the motor, which is buried further within the vacuum, I'm just going to unscrew the motor where it connects to this black section so I can then get it out and clean it. These are Phillips-drive screws, although they are smaller than those ones that were used for the outer casing. So I'm getting my number one Phillips screwdriver, size number one, to undo those screws. For the last one, the motor just wants to separate, so don't drop anything. We have our part that's free here. Set it aside. So there you have it. This piece is now free. This here is where the motor mounted. 1, 2, 3, those areas. This can now be cleaned. And the motor that turns the main brush is right over here. You can just leave that there. And you can see now why I did not want to pull out the entire wire. The wire soldered directly to the motor there, and then it goes into the depths, into another area of the vacuum that I'm not interested in taking apart. Now, as far as taking out this rotating section where that wheel had sat that we had pulled out, if you have debris or something that's caught around it, what we need to do is take out two screws that hold it in. One is right there, you have to rotate it a certain way, and the other is right there. So they're a little sneaky as to how to find them. It looks like a number two Phillips drive screw, so I'll use my regular, let's call it sized, Phillips screwdriver. It's nice to have the magnetic tip on the screwdriver. You can pull the screw right out. Now we can pull this up. There it is. We can clean that out as well, and the area underneath it. If you needed to replace the battery, what you would do now is pull the battery straight up using these handy little tabs. and then pull the connector out that's right over there. And then you could put your new battery in. If your two wheels were soiled as well, you could clean them now. You would just turn them by hand. And they are rubber, so you can wipe them down here. I would not want to go ahead and take the wheels out just if they're dirty. That would looks like it would involve quite a bit more work, as they sit on these little pins here. And to get the pin out, you'd have to push the pin outwards that way, and the cliff sensors are in the way, so you'd have to go through the trouble of removing the cliff sensors. Now we are going to vacuum the vacuum. I'm now going to go ahead and wash all the parts that need washing in the sink and drying them thoroughly, just soap and water. And since this bottom plate goes over everything, and it has no electronics by itself, I'll throw it in and wash it as well. Okay, everything now has been washed, cleaned, and dried. So we're going to start our reassembly. The first thing that I'm going to do is reattach this housing for the brush. As you remember, there's a motor that needs to attach to the side, so we're going to do that first. We'll need our three small screws. Make sure not to pull on the wires too much. You don't want to make anything come loose. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to get this corner and this corner underneath these protrusions, the one over there and the one on the other side right over here. Okay, there we go, they're underneath it. Now the next step is to get the hinge part over here and the one over there installed. So you kind of push it in. There we go. Same down this side. Just when you have to kind of push a little bit. That was not too bad actually. And there we go. That is in. Now we're going to flip it over. Now in here, we're going to pull that silicone piece through the opening. Okay, now that it's through, I'm going to go ahead and push down so that all those little plastic pegs push through the little holes that dotted here, that dot the perimeter of that silicone piece. You end up needing to use your fingers and get really close to make sure that you can get each one on. If you're having trouble with your fingers getting these on, one thing that you can do is take two flat blade screwdrivers and use them together around each of the plastic pegs to get this to fit on. It's easier to get closer to the peg with the screwdriver tips than is with your fingers. All set. While we have this open, we can take the opportunity to put in our new filter. Line up the two tabs here. Push. Next, let's get that pivot wheel in, the one that goes over here, with these two screws. What you're going to need to do is take this piece and make sure that this rectangle, when you place it down, lines up with the rectangle over here. You'll see there's a rectangular feature with screw holes at the bottom. And then you're going to rotate the wheel until you see that the hole is visible and should go all the way down. Spin it around and do the same thing for the other side. Okay, now take your wheel and you're just going to pop it in straight down. You'll hear kind of a double click, one for each side. That way you know that the wheel has come because it's fully engaged. Next, let's put on the cover. This is fairly straightforward. You're just going to take your six screws that you removed before and drive them all in. Okay, let's get our new brush installed. Here's our brand new brush. It already comes with the end caps attached. Fit the square section into the square hole right over there. Push down. There we go. Let's put our retainer cover on. Line it up. Pick it and click down. Good. Finally, let's install the new side brush. This side brush that I'm installing is the one with the bristle tips as opposed to the one with the rubber tips. It tends to not get snagged on the carpet the way the rubber tips do sometimes. I have another video which I'll link in the description that talks about that. All done. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please make sure to like it and subscribe, and leave a comment down below if you have any ideas or suggestions. Thank you. Bye.